There are two types of table relationships in Power BI Desktop, active and inactive. Consider a case like this. Our sales data contains two date fields, an order date and a stock date. And while you can connect both of them to the date field in the calendar lookup table, only one can be active at a time. That's why one of these relationships shows up with a solid line, that's the active one, and the other shows up with a dotted line, which is the inactive one. Now, if you edit both of these relationships, you'll see that one has the checkbox where it says make this relationship active, the other does not. Now, you can toggle these back and forth, but the one catch is that you have to deactivate the active one first before you activate the other. In other words, there can be no point in time where both of those checkboxes are activated. So let me show you what this looks like in the relationships view. Okay, so here we are back in our AdventureWorks model. As you can see, we've got these two date fields in our sales table, order date and stock date. Right now we're connected to the calendar table based on order date, which in this case is our primary date field. But what we can do is grab stock date as well without deleting our order date relationship and drag it up to date so that both are connected. Now you see that it added another relationship, one of which is dotted, which is the second one we added, stock date. The other is solid, order date. That's the active relationship. And remember, if I double click the inactive stock date relationship and try to activate it, it won't let me because it says there's already an active relationship between sales and the calendar lookup. So I've got to deactivate or delete that existing relationship before I can activate this one. So I need to uncheck, press OK. And basically the process looks like this. Start with order date, deselect to make that one inactive. Now I've got two inactive relationships here, and then I can double click and activate my relationship between the stock date and the calendar date. So there you go, I've just swapped the two. And because order date is my true primary date field, I'm gonna go ahead and just reverse what I did. I want this stock date field to be available, but not active. And my order date is the one that I really care about. So there we go. So again, I have both of these relationships in place when I do need them, but can only keep one active at a time.